Okay, I'm Theodore Katsanevas, professor at the University of Piraeus in Greece. I think you know me in the LaRouche movement and the Schiller Institute. I was happy to be with you several times. And now I have the pleasure to discuss with you the current situation here in country, which again, once more, attracts international attention. It's our fate. It appears that it's our fate to attract this attention, this period of time. In any case, at this very moment, we are in the middle of very tough negotiations between the newly elected government of Syriza, of Alexis, the young leader Alexis Tsipras, whom we support, and with our European so-called partners, headed by the Berlin government, Mrs. Merkel and Mr. Schäuble. As it appears now, after many meetings that Alexis Tsipras and the Minister of Economics had, Mr. Varoufakis, in European capitals, according to my view, things appear to be very tough. In the beginning, it appears that the Americans play the good. You know, we have a saying here in Greece that there's the good and the bad policeman. The American plays the good policeman, and the Germans play the bad policeman. So the Americans in the beginning, and Obama also sent a very warm message to the Greek government, and we all felt here that we have the Americans behind us to support us. But in the end of the day, it appears that Mrs. Merkel decided to intervene, and everything appears that the whole negotiation follows a very, 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 very tough line. So the Mrs. Merkel is asking from the Greek government to abolish all claims for against the so-called mnemonio, you know, this policy that has led us to hell all these years, the 6 years now, 6 years of poverty, misery, unemployment we are having in Greece. But Merkel insists on the same line. Alexis Tsipras says that I'm not going to accept what Mrs. Merkel and the European partners want me to do. We want to go out of the memorandum, out of the so-called mnemonio, and we don't want the Troika here in Greece. Of course, both parties send good words, you know, diplomatic, nice words, but up to now, it seems that things are very bad. Also, the European Central Bank, Mr. Draghi, recently announced that the European Central Bank is not going to buy Greek bonds, which means that very soon the Greek banks will be lose the possibility of having money. So we might have a very, very, very tough situation very soon. And under these conditions, the Greek government must decide what to do. There are two ways. Either to take back all its claims, all what they promised to the Greek people, and for this they have been elected. The so-called, we have a Greek word which has been used internationally recently. It is called kolotumba, which means that you turn all the way around. If Alexis Tsipras will follows the Kolotumba, the so-called Kolotumba, then the Greek people are going to get rid of him. He's going to be finished. On the other hand, we see, and we are realistic, if Mrs. Merkel does the Kolotumba and doesn't accept, I mean, doesn't or accepts what Tsipras and the Syriza government proposes, then their position is in a very bad situation, because unfortunately, the at present in the south of Europe, the governments of Spain, Portugal, Italy, they wouldn't like to see something to change in the basic German policy of austerity. If this happens, for example, the Podemos movement in Spain is going to smash Mr. Rajoy in the same country. The same will happen in all Europe. And in the end, this will come up to Berlin. And even now, as you know, Mrs. Merkel and Mr. Schäuble, they have strong opposition for many parts of Europe, and even within Germany. So there is a very, very tough bargaining condition. And indeed, we don't know what is going to happen. What we propose is that in case of the negotiations will not come to a compromise, which is the most possible to happen, we propose to have a referendum here in Greece, with the simple question, yes or no to the Eurozone. We believe that provided that the mass media, which, you know, belong to the oligarchs and belong, they support the euro, they support the rich, they support what, you know, they support, if they keep equal lines between the two positions, we believe that the Grexit will win. In any case, Grexit is on the way, and even the temporary Grexit. As Professor, the economist, the famous German economist, Hans Werner Sinn, has proposed recently, this might be a clever compromise. Not to, you know, to smash Merkel's policy, and at the same time to see what the Greek people really want. If the Greek people decide to get us out of the Eurozone, then we have our all the future in front of us to govern our country. Of course, learn from our mistakes, because it is true that we have done a lot of mistakes in the past. The Greek government has made a lot of mistakes, and create an antagonistic economy by the devaluation of the national currency, the drachma, against the foreign currencies. But on the other hand, if the Greek people decide that the Eurozone is best for them, then the Berlin government can ask anything towards the same direction of poverty, unemployment, and so on that it goes on in Greece. But one problem is, and I left it in the end to stress it, and I'm sure that you are interested here. One problem is that the Berlin government and the United States, towards this confrontation, of course, a confrontation between the West, Germany and the United States towards small Greece. What a confrontation is. Small Greece cannot fight and cannot win in such a confrontation unless there is something behind. And this is the threat of Russia. If Greece will be left to fall under the umbrella of the Russia, which for them is something that they want very, very deeply, this is something that the United States, the Americans, and the Germans, but basically the Americans, will have to think very, very carefully. What I want to say, whether I'm trying to say, is that if the West, this includes the Germany and the United States, pushes Greece to the end, then nobody knows what is going to happen, including the possibility that Greece will be the first country to go with the BRICS, with the Russia. I don't know. I hope the best for our country, the best for all the world. I hope that this will not create or will not lead us to difficult conditions and even a war. Who knows? I'm not the one who can advise the American people, but according to my opinion, I would like to remind that Greece has always has been a very good ally with the American people and the government of America through the centuries. We fight against the Germans in the past, and we are still here. And we don't. I don't think that. I think that we could demand the support of the American people and of the American government, and towards the hope of creating of this country to be developed in a better way. Let us stop the poverty, the unemployment, the misery we are having all these years. And the Americans can do something about it. And I have to remind them that after the Second World War, they created the Marshall Plan. They helped countries like Greece to stand on their knees. Also, I have to remind that the Germans never paid us for all these that they did during the Second World War. They still haven't paid back us of our loans we gave to Germany during these years. And I have to remind to the American people that in the year of 1953, all German debts, or most of the German debts, were finished, were ended under a new development of that era. I think that if you take into consideration the fact that the problem of the debt, of the Greek debt, and the debt of other countries is not only due to our misgovernment, but it also comes out through the international capitalism, of course, Glass-Steagall problem. Glass-Steagall has something about it to do. So I gather that the American people and the American government has to intervene and stop this misery and stop this confrontation. I wish I would be with you, but I send you my greetings and the hopes for a better. For a better tomorrow. Period of time. In any case, at this very moment, we are in the middle of very tough negotiations between the newly elected government of Syriza, of Alexis, the young leader Alexis Tsipras, whom. Okay, I'm Theodore Katsanevas, professor at the University of Piraeus in Greece. I think you know me in the LaRouche movement and the Schiller Institute. I was happy to be with you several times. And now I have the pleasure to discuss with you the current situation here in country, which again, once more, attracts international attention. It's our fate. It appears that it's our fate to attract this attention. This we support and with our European so-called partners, headed by the Berlin government, Mrs. Merkel and Mr. Schäuble. As it appears now, after many meetings that Alexis Tsipras and the Minister of Economics had, Mr. Varoufakis, in European capitals, according to my view, things appear to be very tough. In the beginning, it appears that the Americans play the good.